Welcome everyone, my name is Ian Gillespie and today I'm going to be walking you through Backupify's G Suite Backup product. Today, just before we go too far, I do want to call out the fact that we're going to be focusing on the technology itself, how to perform restores, etc. If you're interested in learning how to set this platform up, there is another video that will focus on that, but I do want to call out it will require you to install the G Suite Backupify Marketplace app prior to performing the setup of this. Additionally, I always like to call out this is a cloud-to-cloud API-based platform. Now, once we've completed the authentication step using that Backupify G Suite Marketplace application, we'll be able to add users to the backup. In regards to adding users, there's going to be four major options. These options are going to include manually adding users on a one-by-one basis or by CSV. These two options give you granular control over who's being backed up, but frankly are quite manual, so most organizations don't go this route. You can add by OU. This will be a one-time addition of who's in this particular OU at this moment in time. Let's add them to the backup. Most organizations, however, choose to use the auto-add functionality which resides under settings. If I click into settings and then go to domain settings, I'll have the ability to turn auto-add on. Now, by default, AutoAdd is on for all shared drives. This means they automatically get pulled into the platform, so you don't have to worry about that. But for users, we can either turn AutoAdd on at the instance level, which means that all users will get pulled in regardless of what OU they're in or anything else like that. Alternatively, we can turn on AutoAdd on an OU by OU level. So perhaps you've got three OUs that contain your critical users and one that's, you know, your resources or something that's just not really relevant. We can go ahead and turn on AutoAdd for the OUs of interest and leave it off for other areas. The AutoAdd job runs once per night, so you may have to wait a little time for this to turn on if you turn it on in the middle of the day. From here, I always like to set expectations around the platform. Initial setup takes a few minutes, and from there we need to do an initial ingest. That's us pulling the data out of those user accounts, shared drives, and more. This usually takes a couple of days, but is highly dependent upon the amount of data, number of shared drives, number of users, and more. So if you're curious in learning more about how long that process may take, I recommend reaching out to our sales team and they can connect you with a sales engineer to determine all of that. On the status page, you'll see some basic statistics fill out as data flows into the platform. Total data, backups in progress, last backup date, and more. This is going to be your one-stop shop to determine, okay, all of my users and their associated services are in good health. Makes things very straightforward. I do always like to call out that this platform does include automated retry logic, as well as on-call engineers that on our side who are monitoring both the software as well as the hardware to ensure that anything issues that arise are being taken care of proactively so you don't have to worry about it. From here, we can begin to talk about recovery and restoration. I'm going to start with mail because it's the simplest, and you'll see when we click into mail, there's four options along the top. Users, which is going to be the users that I can dive into and perform restores on. Search, which will allow me to search across all of these users in one shot. Exports and restores, which will allow me to see any exports or restores that are currently active or have completed. These tools are super useful if, as a user, you ever want to let them know that, hey, you asked for this restore and it is now completed. From the Users tab, I can search for a user by name or by email and go ahead and click into their account. You'll notice that we don't just back up the emails themselves, but all of the organizational structure, which is label structure in Gmail, will be maintained. So whether I'm restoring an entire label or just the entire mailbox, all of that structure will be sent back to the live environment. I can also search for data if I want or dive into any label of interest and granularly select the individual messages that I'm interested in. I can restore data to the original user. This is going to handle your standard deletion events, right? Someone has left the organization or someone has deleted content on their way out the door. You may want to restore it to their account. Additionally, this will allow you to handle anything along the lines of encryption or anything else for that matter. We also have the capability to push this data to another user, and this is super useful as people are leaving or you want to reorganize data as people shift roles. This will allow you to send data from one person to the next, so whether you're doing that on an individual email basis or entire mailboxes, like selecting the entire snapshot to do so, this is a great way to hand on data from one employee to the next. Export will allow you to download data to the local computer. If you ever need a local copy of your mail content, you can absolutely do that. Backup now for on-demand backups as you see fit. This is really useful if someone is being let go from the organization. Perhaps you want to make sure you have a clean copy of the most recent data, just in case they go on a deletion spree on their way out the door. This is a great way to handle that. Finally, we have the Snapshot tool. This is going to allow you to access the previous backup points. We take 3 backups a day, so we can roll back to different points in time and recover whatever data we may need that's been, again, lost, deleted, or encrypted by ransomware. And we'll talk about that ransomware scenario in a few moments. From here, we can move on over to Drive, and you'll notice that Drive is going to have very much the same layout. We have the same 4 options along the top. I can search for a user that I'm interested in, and again, dive into their environment. You'll notice that, again, we do maintain all of that folder structure, so we can restore all of that back to the live environment, whatever I want to do. It's very straightforward. I can search, I can restore to the original user, or again, push this data to someone else. What's really nice here is, unlike Google's tools that make you send everything onto a new user, you can granularly push on what you think is actually relevant. By default, we're going to restore with those sharing permissions intact. However, if there's a scenario where you want to strip those out so the new person can choose who to share those items with, you can absolutely do that as well. Export will allow you to download content to the local computer. Super useful if Google is ever inaccessible for any reason. They do experience outages occasionally. And if for any reason someone needs to work throughout the duration of the outage, you can absolutely pull content down from our platform, send it over to them, and they can continue to work. Backup now, again for on-demand backups, and of course, the snapshot feature to allow for you to recover data that's been lost or deleted. Now, the major use case for the Snapshot tool, particularly in Drive, really focuses around ransomware. The way that ransomware interacts with Google Drive is essentially someone clicks on something they shouldn't. From there, the malware installs on the local computer and begins encrypting everything on the machine. This includes anything that your users have synced from Google down to that computer via file stream, for example. Once that data is encrypted, the encryption is then synced back up to the cloud. Now, in that scenario, Google will tell you, no problem, just use file version histories in order to recover that. But that's a really arduous process using Google's native tools. Additionally, items that don't have version histories, things like PDFs, JPEGs, newly uploaded content, well, those items, you have one version both on your computer and in the cloud. If it's encrypted in both places, there's nothing to roll back to. As a result, you cannot recover files of this type with Google's tools natively. So because of this, our tool is going to make this a much simpler process that ensures that you get all of your data back. So in order to use this platform to recover from a ransomware scenario within Google, it's going to very much mirror what you would do with an on-prem system. Essentially, you're going to clean out the production environment. You're going to come to the platform and roll back in time to a point prior to the encryption event. Select the data you want to recover, be it individual folders or items, whatever you need. Click Restore. And you can also restore an entire snapshot, meaning all of the data that existed within the environment at this date and time. Click Restore again, and you're done. So a very simple process to recover from ransomware, which otherwise you might not be able to do with Google's tools. Now, we don't just back up the My Drive portion of the platform. We do also cover the shared drives portion. And ultimately, this is going to look very much the same as what you saw on the Drive side of things. So I'll go ahead and dive into a team drive. You'll see again that we do have the folder structure maintained. I can search for data. I can restore to the original shared drive or to another one of my choosing if I like. In addition, I can also export data out, backup now, and of course the snapshot tool. Last but not least, we do also backup calendar and contacts. These do feature the same granularity that you would expect, the ability to restore entire calendars or dive in and grab an individual calendar event. Same is true of contacts. I can restore all contacts, or perhaps just an individual contact card. All of these items can be restored to the original location or the original user, or can be pushed to another place of my choosing. Finally, in regards to this platform, we do have a couple of administrative features that are worth calling out. The Manage Administrators tab will allow you to add admins. You can add as many administrators as you would like for no additional charge. Reporting, which will allow you to see system events, which is going to be what the platform is doing, restores, backups, etc. User actions are going to be the actions that your administrators are taking in the platform, so that's going to be your audit log. And finally, on the Settings tab, we can set our retention settings, as well as set any kind of shared settings that we need if we want to turn those off for any reason. And that concludes our Backupify for G Suite demonstration. Thank you very much for your time. And if you have any questions, please feel free to schedule another demonstration with one of our SEs.